Yo, what's good, YouTube? Reptile Noob, Reptile Noob TV. We are live doing an unboxing, not unboxing, an unwrapping, I guess. My wife got me a little something from Amazon, so that's cool. I'll take it, like, hell yeah. Something I needed, too. So what I'm going to do is... Oh, hold on. I'm going to answer bill numbers. My son's messing with the damn camera. There we go. So, I'm going to... No, he's messing with my phone. Whatever. I'm going to open this up, show you guys what it is, what I'm going to use it for. I'm going to show you how to set it up. So, bear with me. Let's get into it. See it right here. Let's crack this open. Just get adjust you guys a little bit more. Come down to my chest. So yeah. So I ordered this for about, I want to say it was about 17, 18 bucks. It's an ipower reptile heat pad. So this is what I got in just right now. I got it for my Slytherin, because right now he's on a Zoomed. I think it's 10 to 20 gallon, and I'm going to put my 10 to 20 gallon over here on my albino spider, which I named her Phoenix, by the way. So Phoenix is going to get her heat pad. I'm going to kill that light. He's going to get a bigger heat pad. I'm hoping it works, because I do got the ipower. Sorry, guys. I do got the ipower thermostat to go along with it. Hold on. Let me grab that for you guys. So this is the ipower thermostat that I got for it as well. So it's just like my other ones I got. Same exact thing. Unboxing. Ooh. So we got the ipower right here. You got your probe. And then you got your electrical. This heat pad will go on and plug into this to control the heat, like I said in my previous video. So ipower, I'm gonna see how that works out. So far the Zoomed ones are working out great for me. I like them a lot, so I figure I'll try the ipower one. It was like $4 cheaper than the Zoomed one, but we shall see. On the back, if you can see right there, I don't know if you guys see that in camera, ball pythons and boas, 82 to 90 degrees. So that's what I'm gonna set it up to. Let's open this thing, check it out. Everybody else uses a cool knife. I got a permanent knife. My teeth. So, crack this heat pad open. Better not draw on my phone, boy. Check it out. Looks pretty decent. Okay, they didn't staple it. Alright, one issue I did have with Zoomed is they put a staple in right here, and it actually was like that close from hitting the fucking heat pad. I don't know if it would have caused any major damage, but still, I mean, you don't want your heat pad. Uh-oh. Nope. They didn't do that, so. Thank you, son. Got a text. Go wait on that. So here's this right here. Got the 3M. So that's pretty cool. ipower reptile heat pad. So that one's gonna go on the bottom of that tank. And I'm gonna show you guys how I set that up as well. First thing you're gonna wanna do is come over here. I really don't wanna mess with these tanks, but I have no choice. So, let's see I'm gonna do this. So I'm kind of in a tight spot. So with me being in a tight spot, check it out.
If you guys want, there they are right there. Two. So
kind of in a tight spot, but we will get it done. So I have it propped up right now. It's a pretty heavy tank. It's not too bad. So I'm gonna scoot it over a little bit. I'm gonna unplug it from its power source. If I can get it out. Unplug. And now I'm gonna try and peel it off. Well, tank is up. Doesn't look like it's gonna do for me. So next big thing, pulling it all the way out like so. The best way to peel it off is when it's hot. Because while it's hot, it's a lot easier to peel off. So, I'm going to pull that off like so. Okay, now we're having some issues. Alright. That mat is peeled off. Sorry, slithering. So right now he has no heat source, so I'm going to try to hurry up and do this shit. But you guys can see the difference. There goes the Zoomed and the iPower. It's a big difference. This one is for, I think, 10 to 20 gallon. So I'm going to put it with this girl over here. Let that set down. Stuck. Got stuck in my shoe. So there goes that. Okay, this is going to be the bitch part. Because I need to line it up to where it's pretty damn good on this tank. This was a lot easier when it was empty. But we're going to do it. What I'm going to do is just turn this tank like that. I'm going to crawl, go down. Call one of my little helpers. Which I might not need it. Nope. Okay. I'll rip this off. Just rip it off the best way you can. Slide that under here. Like so. Really, you don't want no air bubbles. No air bubbles. And I'm hoping it'll get more heat with this thing in there. This thing on there. So, I'm going to come undo this wiring. There's like a zip tie type shit. Something like that. Alright. Now we're gonna come back. I'm gonna put the wire up top so you don't get it stuck. And I'm gonna move this back how I had it. Oh shit. My humidity dropped. So I got that though. I got it propped up by this little weight that I use. So it's not sitting on the floor or onto my pad. And this one sits at the edge, so it's not really a big issue. So if But man, I put these aluminum foils on top.
I don't know if you guys can see that. No, you can't. Well, a little bit right there. But I put the aluminum foil up top and it is holding humidity way better. Way, way better. So,
So I stepped on that. Alright. So now, we'll see if that heats up, see if the heating gets right, and all that good stuff. So we'll let that do its thing. Come over here to my female albino. It's gonna be a long video. I'm probably gonna chop it up, cut it down with a video editor, but this is my albino. So what I'm gonna do with her, the same thing, is I'm gonna put that with that and then plug my ipower in and get that all situated and get her in heated up. So with this being a 10-gallon tank, I'm probably gonna put it this way onto the mat or on the bottom of my tank, but I'm gonna put it sideways and try to get a tack to tack up right there so it controls all that. So let's get started with that. The first thing I'm gonna do is kill this light. She's probably gonna get pissed at me, but
you're a mean one, Mr. Grinch. You really are a heel. You're as cuddly as a cactus. You're as charming as an eel, Mr. Grinch. You're a bad banana with a greasy black peel.
Okay. Then, like I said, I'm just going to put it in the corner of her tank. So let's do that. Let me actually come in here. Probably gonna not need these temperature gauges no more. But I might still use them, put them back in my big tank, and see how they're doing holding humidity. But as you can see now,
I don't know if you guys see that. Let me prop you guys up a little higher. Zoom it in a little bit. Up a little bit more. Zoom it in. So we got what is that? 87.8.
So it's going up. The heat pad is heating up. That's good. And hopefully it feels all warm and cozy in there now.
So let's get back. Zoom you guys back out. Oh. Okay. Zoom it back out. Come back this way. Cause this is where I'm at right now with this bad girl. Oh, getting some Snapchats in. So, Bad Blood Reptiles, what's up, my brother? Check out this new video I'm doing.
But so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come over here. This tank's a lot lighter, so I'm actually pretty happy about that. I'm just gonna turn her sideways. Bring it more. Prop this bad boy right up under here. Like so. And the adhesive for this Zoomed shit, man, it's damn good. So, I know ball pythons, I've been doing a lot of research. They say they like a lot of bottom body heat. Now, scoop this over a little bit so my wire's not going too crazy. So that's like that.
Shout out to Snap-on. I'm a big mechanic. I don't know if you guys know, I work on cars, so that's what I do for a living.
This is more of a hobby for me. Then I'm going to take this ipower. Need some scissors again. Got my handy dandy leaf cutters. Get that in there. Got that. So. Yeah, ever since I've been working with these things, though, man, I love these things. The iPower thing is just so, so good and cheap, like. Right now, I'm just gonna get a tack of some sort, which I have one right here. I'm gonna get this tack it into the wall about right there. I don't know if you guys see that, no. So I put a tack right there. You can see it a little bit. Then I'm gonna put this right here. Like so. Plug this girl in. Like so. There we go. Right now, it's set for Celsius, because when you get them, they're set for Celsius. Let's see. You guys see that? Sorry, guys. So right now it's at 23 degrees Celsius. I'm gonna go ahead and hold the up button. It's on Fahrenheit now. Grab for my heat pad, because she's probably stressing out a little bit. Go ahead and plug that in. Let that heat up my heat pad. She's actually in a good spot, so I'm gonna leave her there. I'm gonna take this and run this wire underneath her, this probe. So let's zoom out. I'm zooming in, hello. Zoom out, there we go. Now we're cooking. So I zoomed out, got my tank. So what I'm gonna do is, she might get a little pissed off right now. So, see if she'll let me grab her real fast. It's okay, girl. It's okay. So there goes her. Right there. Look at that little lick. Being shed. So I'm trying to do this as fast as I can. Baby girl right there. Spider albino. Don't bite me.
Oh.
clean out her water. She got a little scared, a little jumpy at first, but no, RJ. We clean out her water and get her some new water. This back on the top. And that is that. So we got 82.9. It should be heating up. Hopefully it's getting really hot under there so she could go back in there. She's a little scared right now. But besides that, it's Reptile New TV. Hit that comment, like, subscribe button. Hit that share button. I'm going to edit this video. And so it's not too long. It's a pretty long video. But comment, like, subscribe, and share. And that's about it, y'all.